At home or at school, internet access can be the difference between success or failure. And in some homes in the Southern Tier, access is a daily struggle.
In this special report, WENY's Cody Carlson sits down with a local high school senior to see the problems she deals with every day and how Chemung County officials are working to combat the problem.
Think about how much we use the internet every day to complete our daily tasks. For some, it's for pleasure, others for business, but we all want the same thing: high-speed internet. Unfortunately, for some residents in the Southern Tier, including a Horseheads High School senior trying to graduate in the top of her class, that's just not the case.
Riley Burns is a senior at Horseheads High School. On top of being involved in several different school organizations, she works hard to earn her spot in the top 10% of her class. There's just one problem.
It's consistently impossible to do any homework at home.
Riley lives in Lauman, where the internet speed is painfully slow for her and her family. Most of the time, Riley has to go to a public place just to complete her homework.
I've gone to Dunkin' Donuts before, the one near the high school, and then most of the time I go to Barnes & Noble, but they're only open till 9.
And some days, Riley can't even start her homework until 9 p.m. On top of classes, she's involved with the school band, orchestra, and theater program. The last thing she wants to worry about is if she'll be able to do her homework in the comfort of her own home.
And it's something that most people don't have in the back of their mind, that I do, like, can I do my schoolwork tonight? Where do I have to go to do my schoolwork tonight? Or can I go home?
I visited Riley at Barnes & Noble while she was working on homework to see how much easier it was to get her homework done there.
I don't have to wait around waiting for documents to load or my email to open up, and everything just works so much more efficiently.
Dan DeLorme is a physics and astronomy teacher at Horseheads High School. He tells me slow broadband in the home of some of his students is a problem as well.
I've had both. I've had kids who will tell me flat out, listen, I can't do online assignments. I don't have the internet, or not any meaningful form of the internet.
DeLorme says the broadband problem in parts of the Southern Tier could affect the outcome of students' high school careers.
I think it's a big disadvantage because they're not able to practice the way they're tested. How many kids never made it to that top tier because they didn't have the advantage of broadband internet access?
It's even affecting local business owners. Lynn Williams, who is Riley's mom, owns Williams Capital Corp in Elmira. When the family moved to Lauman, she figured she would be able to work from home like she had when they lived in Elmira. But that's not the case.
If something has to be done, then I better get it done before I leave the office for the day, because if I come up here, I'll be very limited as to what I can do.
So what can be done to combat the slow broadband problem? Chemung County officials are working with ECC Technologies, a technology and communications consulting company. They're currently conducting the Broadband Aggregation and Adaption Tool, or BAT, campaign.
There's two purposes of the study. The first is to aggregate the data of who has access to broadband and who doesn't. And then the second prong of it is adoption, finding out the people who don't have it, why don't they have it?
The study can be accessed online at chemung.bat-campaign.com. If you can't access the internet, there's also hard copy surveys available in libraries, town halls, and schools. They're looking for people all over Chemung County to participate.
We need to hear from everybody in the county. Don't just think that because you have access to broadband that we don't need to hear from you. We really, really do.
After the study closes on April 7th, the county gets the results. With that info, they can pursue options on trying to get broadband access to those who need it. Riley hopes this study can make a difference for students in the years to come.
It's important because they need to know that there are people that don't have any internet access that's effective. And that there's not just a few of us, there's a lot of people.
Last month, New York Governor Andrew Cuomo announced $341 million in funding to ensure high-speed internet access across the state. You can submit results for the Chemung County BAT campaign until April 7th. We've provided a link to that study on our website, WENY.com. With this special report, I'm Cody Carlson, WENY News.